डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम अब्दुल रहमान, बायोलॉजी टीचर, CHMHS। टुडे वी विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग द आई, द लास्ट टॉपिक रिलेटेड विथ आई। इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी लर्न अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ आई एंड वी सो यस्टरडे वी सो द दैट हाउ आई वर्क्स, हाउ द लाइट हेल्प्स टू helps for vision. Okay, then the next topic is that binocular vision. Have you heard about binocular? You might have seen binocular. Binocular having two eyepiece. Through two eyepiece we are looking and we are seeing only one object. Many of you may be knowing binocular. Here we have two eyes and both the eyes are making images on the retina, but we are seeing only one object, right? Why? This is binocular vision. Let us see what is this binocular vision. Both eyes are making image and one image will be visible with the help of cerebrum. Images from both the eyes goes to brain, that is in cerebrum, and cerebrum helps to see the object in three-dimensional image. Okay, we are seeing three-dimensional image of an object. This is with the help of cerebrum. Images goes to cerebrum from both the eyes and combined to form or combined to show us one image. This is done by cerebrum. See what is the definition given for binocular vision. The images from two sides of the same object are seen in the left and right eye. From the left and right eye, images from two sides of the object are formed. Okay, when these two objects or two images combine as the result of the activities of the brain, a three-dimensional image of the object is formed. This is called binocular vision. Here we have two eyes, left and right eyes, both will make image and this image will be sent as impulse to brain, and brain analyzes it, combines to form one image, that is three-dimensional image. This is done by cerebrum. Main role is of cerebrum and the technique is known as binocular vision. Here in your notebook you can write what is binocular vision. Here the diagram you can see the figure. Here a person is looking at a fly and image forming in two eyes sending to cerebrum, impulses are going to cerebrum and cerebrum converting it to one image. It is also three-dimensional image when we are viewing it. This technique is known as binocular vision. Okay, write it in notebook. What is binocular vision? Next, the last part of the eye, the defects of eye or defects and diseases related with eye. In page number 28 in the textbook there is a portion to complete. Okay, prepare a note on the eye defects and their remedies. Here below that you can see some space for you, the diseases which you know, the defects which you know. You have to write the diseases which you know. You write it, I'm not telling that. Okay, you write some diseases which you no, myopia is given. Last year you learned about myopia. In physics you learned about myopia. It is related with lens. And there are some more diseases, defects you learned earlier. You write it. Then let us see the defects which are familiar in our textbook or given in our textbook to learn. We will go one by one. When we learn about any defect or disease, any defect, either eye or any other disease, I told you earlier that mainly disease name of the disease or defect, then reason and symptom. This is the point related to disease to study. Okay, reason and symptom, then remedy. These are the three main points: name of the disease, reason and symptom, karanam, lakshanam. Then remedy is pariharam. Okay, let us see one by one. First, you take night blindness. Night blindness is a defect generally affecting eyes. What is this night blindness? Night blindness is nothing but the person with night blindness won't be able to see the things clearly in dim light. Dim light vision will not be perfect. Let us see what is the reason. Due to the deficiency of vitamin A. Here, previously when we learned the chemistry of vision, there we saw rhodopsin. I think you remember rod cell contain rhodopsin. Rhodopsin are having retinal and opsin. Retinal is a derivative of vitamin A. When there is deficiency of vitamin A, it will affect retinal. It will affect the working of retinal, mainly helping in night vision. Okay, this is the reason. Deficiency of vitamin A. Vitamin A food, I told you yesterday about food containing vitamin A. Carrot contains vitamin A. There are radish contains vitamin A. There are a lot of leafy vegetables which contain vitamin A. You have to consume more vitamin A for the perfection of eye, perfection of vision. Okay, and the symptom will be no clear vision in dim light. In dim light, the person with night blindness won't be having perfect vision. Remedy is consume more vitamin A. By consuming more vitamin A, we can prevent the night blindness. Go through the text also, you'll get some more detail about night blindness. Then secondly, color blindness. See, let us see what is color blindness. Color blindness, from the word itself you may understand, color, blind in color, some color will not be able to see. There are different colored objects. We are seeing the things easily and we are knowing all the colors. In case of color blindness, let us see what is the reason and symptom. This is due to the defect of cone cells. Here earlier you studied color vision is helping by cone cells. Cone cells are having photopsin or iodopsin. The pigment photopsin or iodopsin is there. Then color vision is done by cone cells. Three type of cone cells are there that you learned earlier, helping for red, green and what else? Red, green and blue. Okay, here the defect or in case of color blindness is due to defect of cone cells which detect red and green. The color which are detecting with the help of red and green, it will be defective. Which defect? Red and green color, person with this defect cannot distinguish green and red color. If a person cannot distinguish green and red color, he won't be able to see many things. It's a combination. Okay, here in signals, the person with color blindness won't be able to drive. He won't get a license. Why? Green signal will not be visible. Okay. This is what color blindness, and the defect is due to defect of cone cells. Okay. Then there is no proper remedy for it. It is genetic. Okay. That is why its remedy is not given. Inborn. Person will be having inborn. This is a genetic defect. Then let us see the next defect. Before that, night blindness, color blindness. These are the two important defects. Then there is xerophthalmia. Xerophthalmia is a defect related with eye, and it is due to prolonged deficiency of vitamin A. Prolonged deficiency. Here, due to deficiency of vitamin A, you may get night blindness. If it is prolonged, it is continuing, then it will become xerophthalmia. Okay. Here, the conjunctiva and cornea become dry and opaque. The conjunctiva and cornea become dry and opaque. What it means? You know conjunctiva. Conjunctiva is near the cornea. It produces mucus that you learned earlier. While studying all the disease, you should know the structure and function of eye well. Okay, then only this study will be easy. Here, prolonged deficiency of vitamin A, due to that conjunctiva become dry and opaque. Dry, you know the meaning of dryness, varandrika. Then opaque means conjunctiva and cornea become dry and opaque. Opaque means it will not allow to pass light. This is what opaque. Opposite of opaque is transparent. Okay. Then let us see the treatment. Treatment here also vitamin A. Consume more vitamin A, we can prevent xerophthalmia to an extent. Then see cataract, the next disease. What is this cataract? Cataract in Malayalam is timidum. You might have heard about this. Okay, here in this condition, lens of the eye become opaque, resulting in blindness. Lens, it is affecting the lens. Lens become opaque. And this can be rectified. This can be corrected by replacing the lens with an artificial one through surgery. Okay, surgical replacement is there. It's a remedy is there for cataract. Proper remedy is there, but the thing is that we have to consult the doctor in time. We have to give treatment in time. Okay, gradually this is not on sudden. Gradually this is affect the lens. Okay, then next see the glaucoma. Another disease is glaucoma. Next we will see the glaucoma. Here the glaucoma is a defect affecting the vision. Okay, here defective vision due to the increased pressure when the reabsorption of aqueous humor obstructed. You learned about aqueous humor. Where is this aqueous humor? Aqueous humor is in between cornea and lens. There is a chamber named aqueous chamber and there is aqueous humor. It's a watery fluid. Here this aqueous humor is providing nourishment to the cells of eye. That we learned it. Okay. Here glaucoma is caused due to the reabsorption of aqueous humor does not occur. If the reabsorption of aqueous humor does not occur, it causes an increase in the pressure inside the eyes. Reabsorption means aqueous humor is normally produced from blood and reabsorbed to blood. If there is any obstruction in that, it may lead to the defect named glaucoma. Okay, and this causes damage to the retina and photoreceptors. Later, when it becomes severe, it may damage the retina and photoreceptors, and ultimately, it may lead to blindness. In the primary stage, if it is treated, it will be well and good. It's okay. It can be treated. Here, treatment is by laser surgery. Early treatment. Here, in all cases of eye, early treatment is better. Once the things become worst, it can lead to blindness. So whenever we are having any problem with eyes, immediately you should consult a doctor or should take proper treatment. Glaucoma is also can be dangerous if it is not treated in the early stages. Yeah, mainly it is due to the defect in the reabsorption of aqueous humor. Go through the text, okay? Then you will get some more details. Then let's see the next one, conjunctivitis. Chengannu conjunctivitis is an infection of bacteria or virus, causes red eye with pain. It is by bacteria or virus, there is a reason. Then symptom is red eye with eyes with pain. There will be mucus and watery tears will be produced in large amount. This is the symptom of conjunctivitis, and there is antibiotic for this. There is remedy, treatment, and rest is required for conjunctivitis. These are the different diseases what it is in your syllabus, mainly night blindness, color blindness, then we have xerophthalmia, cataract, glaucoma, conjunctivitis. Other two diseases are given here, astigmatism and presbyopia. It is not in your topic anyway. You can go through it. These are the different type of disease. Now you should make a table showing defect or disease of eye, then reason and symptom. Then you write the remedy also. These are the three main points while learning diseases of eye. Okay, then there is a topic in the textbook, there is protection of eye. What are the things to be taken care of to ensure the health of eyes? You have to write a brief, right? Make a note in your notebook, note down it. What are the things to be taken care to ensure the health of eyes? You write of your own, you know it. Just think about it and write it in your notebook. This is an assignment. Then we will go to the next part. This is all about eye. We learned about the structure of eye, functions of eye, function of eye, how the eye works. Then we discuss the different type of defects or disease causing the eye. Let us go to the next topic, that is ear. Next, sense organ. Here, you know about ear, we have two ears, right? This is the diagram showing the structure of ear, section of ear. Here we have left and right ear. Let us see the details of ear. First, you observe the figure. Here we have three parts in the ear, mainly outer ear, middle ear, inner ear. These are three parts. We can differentiate into three parts. First, let us see the outer ear. These are the three parts. Here, this part is outer ear. Okay, then middle ear. Then we have inner ear. These three parts. We will go one by one. Let me try to show you a external ear. Here, this is external ear. Okay, the symbol diagram. Okay, here outer part we can say pinna. This is outer part. This is pinna. Called it as pinna. Then this second part named ear canal, then ear drum or tympanum, eardrum or tympanum. These are the three parts involved in external ear, outer ear, pinna, Malayalam chevikuda, നമ്മൾ പുറത്ത് കാണുന്നത് ചെവി, ചെവിയുടെ ഔട്ടർ പാർട്ട് ഇസ് കോൾഡ് എ സ്പിന്നർ, പി ഐ എൻ എൻ. ദെൻ ദ കനാൽ, ദ ബിഗിനിങ് കനാൽ ഇസ് ഇയർ കനാൽ, ദെൻ ഇയർ കനാൽ എൻഡിങ് ഇൻ ഇയർ ഡ്രം ഓർ ഇയർ ഡ്രം ഓർ വി ക്യാൻ കോൾ ഇറ്റ് ആസ് ടിംബാനം. ലെറ്റ് സി ദാറ്റ് ഇയർ ഇയർ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഇയർ കനാൽ, ഇയർ കനാൽ ഇസ് ഇയർ, ദെൻ ടിംബാനം ഇസ് ഇയർ. This is external ear. External ear in detail is given. Here is the pinna. See the function of pinna. Pinna carries sound waves to the auditory canal. Carries sound waves to the auditory canal is the role of pinna. Then auditory canal. Auditory canal or ear canal. See what is the role of ear canal. Carries sound waves to the tympanum. And meantime, last class we saw in eye there is stimuli. What is the stimuli of eye? Light. Here, if for ear, it is sound waves. Sound waves are the stimuli. When we talk, there will be waves generated. Waves generated in the ear. In the air, and these waves will reach the ear through air. This is what sound wave, and this is working as stimuli for ear. The stimuli enters through the ear canal or auditory canal. Auditory canal, the role of auditory canal carries sound waves to the tympanum. It carries sound waves to the tympanum. Tympanum is here. Okay, sound waves pass through this canal and reach the tympanum. Tympanum or ear drum. You can see the tympanum here. Then another facilities or another features of auditory canal is having small hairs and wax. In this canal there is small hair and wax. Wax means chippy. Okay. So there is small hair and wax prevent dust and foreign particles from entering the ear. This is the mean of protection. Ear, any insect or dust, if it enter in the ear, it will be stopped by our facility, that is wax, ear wax and small hairs. This is about auditory canal. Then the third part is tympanum. In tympanum, see, it is a thin circular membrane, very thin membrane. That is why it is telling should not put any sharp object in the ear. It may defect tympanum. Here it won't be, there is no much length of for this. Very, it is very short. If you put pencil in the or any sharp object in the ear, immediately it may reach tympanum. So you should not clean ear with any sharp object. If anything happens to ear, any pain or something, go directly to the ENT specialist and treat there. Don't make self treatment in case of ear. The reason is tympanum. Tympanum is a very thin circular membrane, very thin membrane, very thin membrane, and it separates middle ear and external ear. You saw this diagram, middle ear and external ear. Here the middle ear is there. External ear, outer ear, middle ear. This is a separating area. Okay. Then the role is it vibrates in resonance with the sound waves. When the sound waves comes to the through the auditory canal, this tympanum will be vibrated. This is the role of tympanum. It vibrates. It receives the sound waves in the beginning. Okay. This is about the external ear. Now let us see the next part, this middle ear. You saw the different parts of external ear. There is pinna, then auditory canal and tympanum. These are the three main parts of external ear. Then we have middle ear. This is an enlarged part of middle ear. Let us see what are the things in middle ear. Middle ear contains ear ossicles. You might have heard about ear ossicles. Ear ossicles are nothing but three bones named malleus, incus and stapes. These are the three bones named as ear ossicles. This is an important part in middle ear. It is attached, malleus is attached with the tympanum. The vibration of tympanum will be received by malleus and it is be carried to incus, then it will be carried to stapes. Then in middle ear there is another important part named eustachian tube. Eustachian tube connects the middle ear and the pharynx in the throat. Okay, middle ear and pharynx, throat is connected with ear. Okay, and the role is protect the tympanum by balancing the pressure on either side of the tympanum. This protect the tympanum by balancing the pressure on either side of the tympanum. This is the role of eustachian tube. These are the two important parts in the middle ear. Here see once again, three bones, malleus, incus, stapes. Another information, stapes is the smallest bone in our body. Stapes. Okay, very soft bones. Okay, it can be seen in the ear. This is all about middle ear. Then we have internal ear. See the internal ear here. Let us see the different parts of internal ear. Internal ear contains three semicircular canal. Three semicircular canal is there. Inside there is space. This canal is having space inside. There are some fluid. We will learn it in the next part. Then now just study the parts. Internal ear, three semicircular canal. Then cochlea. There is a part named cochlea. Ochindi agridiran. Okay. Then here inside there is a space. If you open it, you can see the space inside. There is a fluid also. We will study it. Then there is auditory nerve. Nerve is connected from auditory nerve and vestibular nerve is there. Two type of nerve is there. We will see the difference while studying the function in detail. Auditory nerve connected with cochlea and vestibular nerve is connected with vestibule. Vestibule is a base part of the semicircular canal and it is in between cochlea and semicircular canal. This space is known as vestibule. There is also a fluid inside it. While studying the detailed function, we will learn about it. Just now, you understand the parts. We learned the different parts of ear. Mainly three parts: outer ear, middle ear and inner ear. Then in outer ear we saw pinna, auditory canal and tympanum. Then in middle ear, ear ossicles, malleus, incus, stapes. Then we have eustachian tube. Then in the internal ear, we have semicircular canal, then cochlea. These are the two important parts. Then nerve, auditory nerve. The nerve related with hearing is connected with auditory nerve and there is vestibular nerve. And you saw the vestibule. I told you there is some fluid in it. We will study it in the next class. Okay. Here, before closing, ear is having two functions. One function, all of you know it, hearing. Then one more function is there, that is balancing. Ear is helping for balancing also. Okay, the vestibule and vestibular nerve etc. are related with balancing. We will see it. We will see it in the next class. Today we will wind up. And you first of all, before going to the before coming to the next class, all of you should know the different parts of ear. Then only you will be able to learn the function properly. The functions I told you: hearing and balancing. To learn hearing and balancing, how hearing takes place, what is the mechanism in hearing, what is the mechanism in balancing. To learn that, you should know the different parts of the ear well. Okay, different parts. Structure and function. You have to make a table, prepare a table showing parts of ear and its feature or peculiarity. Then draw the diagram of ear and label the parts. You have to draw the diagram as a whole. This diagram you can draw it in your notebook. It is easy to draw. External ear I have shown you. External ear. Once again, I'll try to roughly I'll show you this. Draw the external ear. Then here the ear canal, auditory canal. Then here after this you can draw the malleus, incus, stapes, three bones. Okay, then you draw the eustachian tube. Then the internal ear. Three semicircular canal and cochlea you can draw here. Okay, nerves, two type of nerves are there. This is a very rough diagram, just I'm drawing with finger. Okay, there is no pointer in this phone, that is why. Okay, don't draw the diagram in this way. You draw a neat diagram. It is while looking it looks difficult, but it is easy to draw. Okay, you have to try to draw in this three dimensional way. This is three dimensional diagram. You draw this diagram and label the parts and learn it well. Before coming to the next class, you should learn the learn all the parts, and you will be ready to study the function of ear, that is hearing and balancing. Thus we wind up the class. Thank you for listening.